الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, sons and daughters of the future of Islam, insha'Allah, Rabbil Alameen. Always when you're performing any of those pillars of Islam, think of the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why He subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed upon us those pillars of Islam. You want it to be the best of the best Muslims ever? Take those five pillars of Islam seriously. As the basis of Islam. Okay? As the basis of Islam. And see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would help you in your life, in each and every single aspect of your life. Especially when it comes to Siyam Ramadan. We'll be talking about some of Ramadan and the hikmah, the wisdom behind it, and so on and so forth, more and more and more. Then what, Ya Allah, we have to do in order to be the best of the best ummah ever. Okay, Muhajirin, yes, Ansar, yes, living together, yes, having some business to keep going, you know, and to help your family members and so on and so forth, yeah. Zakah. What, Ya Allah? You're performing the fasting of the month of Ramadan? Yes, Ya Allah. We'll do it the way it should and as you told us. During the month of Ramadan, while you're fasting, from what you own, take some of it and give it to the needy people. Because in Al-Madinah there, don't consider everyone, every single one who came to Islam or practicing Islam has enough to sustain his life, to live his life. Some among you are very, very, very poor. Especially some of the Muhajirin coming from Mecca to Al-Madinah. Because the majority of them, you know why they were very poor? They left all what they own in Mecca before they migrate to Al-Madinah. That was the harshest and the hardest condition the kuffar of Mecca put upon some of them. You want to leave? Yes. You want to show Muhammad? Yes. You want to go to Al-Madinah? Yes. You have business? Yes. Leave it here. Don't take a penny from your business. Leave it, literally. Subhanallah, yani humiliating them and putting them in a situation, I leave my business and go to Al-Madinah with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How come I leave my business? How come I lost my business? The whole business, all what you own, leave it here in Mecca with the kuffar in order to force them to give up Islam. Say, no, I'm not gonna give up my business. I'm gonna stay here. I'm not gonna go with Muhammad. I'll stay with you. Going back to the kufr, waliyadu billah. Many of the Sahaba. Suhaib al-Rumi, Suhaib. Yani they put that hardest condition on him. No single penny you take with you if you're planning to go to the Hijrah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I say, take it. I don't need it. You keep it. That's a long distance before he reached Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the help and grace and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw Suhaib coming from far distance, where none of the Sahaba would feel or realize or saw subhanallah Suhaib coming except Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling him from a far distance, Rabih al bay'u Aba Yahya Rabih al bay'. You have won the deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by leaving everything behind you in Mecca. So can you imagine Suhaib there in al-Madina with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, leaving all his business, his money, his wealth and everything, and in al-Madina, okay, you take that issue seriously, Suhaib? Yes. Fasting the month of Ramadan? Yes. Okay, Suhaib, while you're fasting the month of Ramadan during the whole month, pay your zakah. Ya Allah, you don't have money. Ikhwa, can you imagine? Can you imagine? Subhanallah, ya Rabbil Alameen. I don't have money to pay zakah. Zakatul Fitr. Where, يعني, it is not that much. Even nowadays, when I say it is $15 per person in the household, give it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who are in need to sustain their life and so on and so forth. And the majority, not only Suhaib, wallahi, of the muhajireen in al-Madinah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the poorest of the poor, even the richest among them in Mecca, like Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu arda, left everything in Mecca in order to keep loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and abiding by the teaching of Allah, to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Madinah. And al-Ansar knew that about Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu arda because of his trips, meeting them and everything. When they saw him, Uthman, yes, no money? No. No wealth? No. No business? No. No nothing? No. I'm here just by myself. One of the poorest of the poor. This is what some of Ansar told Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. Come, Uthman, I have a house. Share me that house. I have money. Share me my money. I have this. Come and do this. And in a situation like this, when I'm very, very, very difficult situation financially, what would be the answer? What would be the answer, Jamalian? Jazakallah khairan, Allah, yeah, half of the money would be more than enough. And I live with you in your house instead of going someone else and pay the rent or buy a house. Okay, thank you so much. I really, really, really appreciate it. But guess what Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anka wa ardaka ya Uthman told the Sahaba, Al-Ansar there, wallahi, wallahi, I wish each and every single one of us who has wealth today does exactly what Uthman ibn Affan did. Telling all of them, Dulluni ala suq al-Madinah. Show me where the market of al-Madinah is. Market? Uthman, are you serious? Are you up here okay? How you go to the market and you have no money? What you're gonna pay? How you're gonna pay for the things you're gonna get from the market there? Dulluni ala suq al-Madinah. Show me where the market of al-Madinah is. And they show him here, the market, Uthman. Show us what you're gonna do. Yani you're gonna ask, you know, Mahmoud, Amir, or Farooq, you know, give me money because you're super rich and here you're having business. La wallahi, la wallahi. You strike wonderful deal with them. Can I buy some of your products? And let me go to the market in order to sell it. Once I sell that product, I would come back to you and pay you the value of what I had from you. And they keep going on and on and on and on. Rabbi Uthman, take whatever you want to take. Look at the amana. Look at the trust. Look at the deal. Can you imagine you have nothing in your pocket, nothing in your account in the bank. And you go to someone else and say, can I have some products in order to sell it, and then I would come to you and say, are you kidding? Get out of here. So go have or try to have a loan from the bank. In a bank, should I say bank? What is happening to our banks here in America, by the way? You follow the news? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from that disastrous situation with the banks in America. And stop it at that point, subhanallah. You go to the bank, you say, hey guys in here, I want to see the director of the bank. Yeah. Can I borrow some money from you to establish a business? What they tell you? What they tell you, Mahmoud? No, Allah, yeah. What they tell you? You did like this. What it means?
Interest.
Huh?
You want interest.
Interest, the first thing. What else?
Collateral.
Huh?
Collateral.
Put conditions in you in order to borrow some money in order to go and run your business. You will never be able if you just go there like this. I am such and such. The only thing you do have there when you go to the bank, your name. I am, give me money in order to establish everything. Are you kidding? Are you serious? Are you crazy? You lost your mind? Get out of here. Go somewhere else. That's for Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu arda to Ansar in al Medina. Give me some products. We trust you. We love you. You're coming from Mecca to here. Lift everything in your business, everything in your money, everything in your wealth. Some family members even back there in order to come with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to see you, Uthman. We dream of seeing you. Now we see you. Take whatever you want to take from the products. Go establish your business. And Uthman radiallahu anhu arda kept going on and on and on till he became in al-Medina again one of the wealthiest people in al-Medina by the help and grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya akhwa, this is the way we deal with Allah when it comes to money. Sometimes because we think, I don't have that much money to do this. I don't have money, you know. You have been asking us, Dr. Hamdi, to pay the insurance of the masjid. We don't have money for that. I'm going to ask you after the salah, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, too. Yeah. Having the insurance, and then in a week, I did not check our mail yet, but I'm sure it is in the mailbox there. The ad-daraib. What the daraib is? The taxes. And I brought last year, by the way, the envelope of the taxes. And I declare it in front of all of you. One brother who's among you, as if I'm speaking now. Now. Show me that envelope, Dr. Hamdi. I show him the envelope. The taxes, see, I will take care of it, all of it. Don't worry about it. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. One of you, not somewhere else, one of you among you now, wallahi, now, having the spirit of the Sahaba, ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'een. We're willing, Ya Rasulullah, to sacrifice for anything to keep Islam in the best shape ever. Including Uthman radiallahu anhu Allah. Till the point, يعني the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, muhajirin and ansar, we say, we know Uthman. If we go anywhere, sit on the ground and play with the dirt there, and keep having dirt out, he will find, by the blessing of Allah, by his blessed hands of Allah and the fingers, he will find money there, under the dirt. The help and grace and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when it comes to the Zakatul Fitr, come forward and do it. And the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inshallah Rabbil Alameen, will be, no, wait a minute. It is not only Zakat al-Fitr. Ya Sahabatu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have money? Sayyidina Uthman, I don't have that much, ya Allah. But The other ones. And of course, all of them there. Abu Bakr, Osman, Ali, all of them, all of them, all of them. You have money? Yes. Zakatul mal. You have the wealth? Yes. For 1 year? Yes. Calculate that 2.5%. Pay it to the needy people. Wallahi, 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 may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me to say that. For so many years, a lot of Muslims do have the money, do have the money for so years and never pay zakat al-mal. Last week I was saying, you want to liberate Palestine? You want to have Palestine free? You want to regain Al-Quds? Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa? Calculate it. Calculate it this way, wallahi. I might sound crazy, but this is the way I calculate it. We are 1.9 billion Muslims. 1.9 billion Muslims. For each and every single one of that Muslim population, pay only $1. $1. $1. You come up with $1.9 billion. Palestine will be liberated. Wallahi will be liberated. Utilize that money in order to say, this is our jihad for Allah. You want to make it on a monthly basis? Do it. And multiply that $1.9 billion times 12. See how much money you will have? Liberate Palestine with that money. Or give to the needy there. I'm saying $1 from each and every single member of each family. But we don't. Since 48. And I'm wallahi wondering. And I'm wondering till sometimes, subhanAllah, I feel that I'm losing my mind. Maybe I'm not thinking right. Am I thinking right? Wallahi. No, tell me, no, I'm exaggerating the situation. Or zakah for you muhajirin and ansar, along with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether you have it or not, but take care of each other. I am a muhajir from Mecca. You are a settler of Al-Medina and you have money. Pay zakah to that who is in need, because he left everything back in Mecca. Can you imagine those pillars of Islam under the leadership of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The shahada is there. The salah is there. Fasting the month of Ramadan is there. The zakah is there. But wait for a while till inshaAllah go to Mecca to perform Hajj, inshaAllah. You see how Islam is very comprehensive, giving us the best way of life, and you need nothing else to think about it, to live your life, the best life ever, the happiest life ever. What else we need? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, and He knows subhanahu wa ta'ala what is the best for us to live our life, as He did with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the Muhajirin and Ansar, establishing the first state under His leadership to be in thousands of Muslim believers and Sahaba to go everywhere with Islam till they reach here. Subhanallah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين يا رب العالمين اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا وفك أسرانا وكن لنا ولا تكن علينا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا اللهم برحمتك عمنا واكفنا شر ما أهمنا وعلى الإيمان الكامل والكتاب والسنة توفنا وأنت راض عنا اغفر اللهم لنا ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولأبنائنا ولكل المسلمين أجمعين إلي هذا حلنا لا يخفى عليك وهذا ضعفنا ظاهر بين يديك فعاملنا بالإحسان إذ الفضل منك وإليك واختم لنا بخاتمة السعادة أجمعين. يا عباد الله، إن الله يأمركم بثلاث وأنهاكم عن ثلاث، إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه يزيدكم. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمني ويرحمكم الله، وأستودعكم الله.